Hello, this is Megan Dutrow, and today I'm going to go over virtual visits for team members for scheduling, canceling, and rescheduling virtual visits and the day of visit for a virtual visit. So as you can see on my screen, this is the standard work for scheduling, canceling, and rescheduling. The first step that you have to do is schedule in Cerner. So if you're scheduling a new virtual visit appointment, you'll need to use the correct virtual visit appointment type if available. If it's not available, use a return appointment type and make sure you are putting in the reason for visit that it's a virtual visit. If you are rescheduling any appointments to virtual visits, follow steps 2 through 4. In this, you need to right click on the appointment you're changing to a virtual visit, select actions, then click modify. You will then select the detail tab. And on the reason for visit, you will add in all caps, virtual visit dash whatever the reason for exam was. And then click OK, and you will see that the reason for exam has been updated in the schedule and the ambulatory organizer. The next part will be to schedule on the American Well platform. So while you're talking to the patient, you need to ask if they have downloaded or ever used the virtual visits. It's the IU Health video visit app. It looks like this. The patient needs to download it and needs to sign up by entering their name, email address, address, and a little bit of other information. So make sure the patient is doing this while you're talking to them. So once the patient downloads the app, you can go on to www.iuhealthvirtualvisits.org to log in. So here's what the login screen looks like. You will use your credentials that you were given, and it's just your username, @iuhealth, and the password is whatever password you created or was given. So to schedule an appointment, you will click schedule online visit on the upper left-hand corner. If you're scheduling for a child, you'll want to check the checkbox here, and that will have you put in the parents' names or the parents' email. So the easiest thing to do is to get the email from the patient, or ask what email they use to sign up. So we will test on me here, and then you'll click next, and then you'll see the list of patients. Make sure you select the correct patient and click next. Then you'll want to schedule with the specific provider, so whoever you're scheduling for. You can just search, click enter, and you'll see it pop up below. We're going to schedule on the test provider. And you click next. And then you want to schedule the same appointment time you scheduled in Cerner. So as you can see, it only has 30, 45, and 15. So if your provider is a 2040 provider, schedule as close as you can to that appointment time. So if the appointment's at 1:40, I recommend scheduling a 1:30 appointment. If the appointment's at 2:20, I recommend scheduling a 2:20 appointment or 2:15 appointment. So let's schedule a 2:15 appointment and click next. Insurance information will come up on here. It will most likely be blank if the patient did not input this while signing up. If they did input this while signing up, information will pop up. You do not need to do anything with this. You need to skip over the insurance section. All the insurance will be done within Cerner. So now you can see the visit details. You can confirm the patient name, the provider, the visit date and time. You can see the patient cost is $0, but you will want to add a note to the patient that states billing. You will be billed the same way as you are in person. And then you will click complete visit setup. So now the appointment was sent to the patient. So now if you need to cancel or reschedule an appointment, you will need to go to providers down here, and you will need to click on the provider that the patient is seeing that needs to be canceled or rescheduled. You can go and look for the different dates when appointments are. And so when you find that appointment you need to cancel or reschedule, you'll need to click on it. You'll see the patient's name. You can either cancel appointment, You can reschedule appointment, and it just looks like this, where you change it to another date, choose a new time, make sure you look at AM and PM, click next, and then you complete the visit setup, and it will bring over all your information. And if you want to cancel, all you have to do is cancel. You can put a note to the patient if you need to, and you can cancel the appointment. So that is how you schedule, reschedule, or cancel appointments within the American Well app. Make sure you are going back into Cerner and scheduling, rescheduling, or canceling appointments as well. The next standard work we'll go over is the actual day of the virtual visit. So there are multiple options that you can proceed with. The first option is that you check in all virtual visit patients at the beginning of the day or in advance to complete the Cerner registration and arrival in Cerner. So when you're scheduling any patients too, same day, I recommend that you check them in and complete the registration. The other option is to check in virtual visits, visit patients at the same time they arrive. And with that, you can follow steps 2 through 3. So you have to log into the IU Health virtual visits website, and you can go into your waiting rooms where you can then see the patients who are waiting. And if you need to, you can actually chat with the patient too. If you look at the yellow bubbles here and just chat them, anything they need to know, if a physician is running late, anything that they would need to do. So make sure you complete the registration and arrival in Cerner once you see them in the waiting room too. And so for charging scrubbing personnel, make sure when you see the GT modifier linked to the E&M code that the service site is changed to Telehealth 02. And that is only for charge scrubbing if your office does this. So that is all the standard work for team members for virtual visits, scheduling, rescheduling, canceling, and the day of virtual visit. Thank you.